Hello, hello. My name is Marvin Mandati. I'm a former student at the Commonwealth School. Welcome to the Science Hub. I'll be tackling trigonometry, which is the fourth topic in Form 4. So, trigonometry 3, in Book 2, we learned trigonometric ratios, which is the subtotal. This be theta. So means that sine theta is equivalent to opposite of hypotenuse. These are opposite and these are hypotenuse. Cosine theta is equivalent to adjacent to hypotenuse. However, this is the adjacent. And finally, tan theta is opposite to adjacent. So, we use another ratio in triangle. And this is theta. We call this H. Call this A and B. Using what we learned in trigonometry 1, we say that cos theta is equivalent to adjacent, which is being of hypotenuse, which is church. So we want to get the value for B. So what do we do? We cross multiply. Where we get B to be H cos theta. So we also use sine theta, which is opposite of our hypotenuse, which is A over H. And since we want to get A, we'll cross multiply and say that A is H sin theta. If we substitute the values to the triangle, that is H sin theta. And it will be using the Pythagoras theorem, which states that x bar plus b squared is equal to 6 bar. Let's take let's substitute h sin theta. So h sin theta squared plus h cos theta squared will be equivalent to c, which is the hypotenuse. We use the letter h squared. So when you open the brackets, we get h squared sine squared theta plus h squared cos squared theta is equivalent to h squared. However, we learned that there is a common letter, which is x squared. So we need to use x squared, x squared, x squared, and come out with sine squared theta plus cos squared theta is equivalent to 1. You can also break this into ways. Sine theta squared is equivalent to 1 minus cos and also cos theta is equivalent to 1 minus sin square theta. We also learn that tan theta is equivalent to cos theta, sin theta or cos theta, which is applicable this way. We know that cos theta is adjacent to one hypotenuse, and sin theta is opposite to one hypotenuse. So we say that sine of cos theta to be opposite of our hypotenuse, all of our adjacent of the hypotenuse. So if we multiply, we get opposite of our hypotenuse times hypotenuse of our adjacent. But we come with opposite, which is the outer theta, which I'll illustrate here. And also, square things to say that tan square theta can also be sin square theta or cos square theta. Let's do an example. We have been told that we show that cos theta sine square theta plus cos cube theta all over sin theta is equivalent to half. So, using what we learned there, say that cos theta is common on the numerator part, so that factor it out. Say that cos theta sin square theta plus cos square theta or sin theta is equal to half one. So using the first equation, we say that sin square theta plus cos theta square is 1. So we substitute this to 1 and multiply cos theta. By the way, we just get cos theta 1 over sin theta. We also learn that tan theta is equal to sin theta or cos theta. So cos theta over tan theta will be the reciprocal, which is 1 over tan theta. So this is equivalent to 1 over tan theta. Previously, this equation, we told that if tan theta is there, we just have to substitute this 1 over tan theta. It's now a prove that this equation is exactly what we are going to get from it. Using another example for clarification, say that, show that. show that sine theta cos theta. Sine theta cos theta squared. Sin theta minus sin cubed theta. So in this we know that cos theta is cos squared theta, as you learned there, is 1 minus sin squared theta. So we can substitute this, we say that sin theta into cos squared theta, which is 1 minus sin theta squared. However, if we substitute, we'll get sin theta minus sin cubed theta, which is much with the answer right there. So, at this junction, I would like to go to the waves, whereby using this graph, the equation is y sine x plus 45, and there is also y is equal to sine x. So the questions would be like, you define the amplitude, the period, or maybe the phase angle. So if we start with the amplitude, is the maximum displacement of the wave, maximum displacement of the wave above or below the x-axis. So in this case, the maximum displacement is 1, negative 1. As it is. So the amplitude can either be 1 or negative 1. When you are told to define the period, which is the period is the interval after which the wave repeats itself, that means after it has covered an oscillation. Would like to correct myself. Yeah. The amplitude of this graph is supposed to be 1, sorry. Back to the period part. We've been told that it's the interval after which the wave repeats itself. That is after one oscillation. However, if we look at the graph, first graph, let's call it A. Secondary, let's call it B. So the amplitude of A and B is the same, which is 1. But the period for A is, supposed to be at 3. It's supposed to be at 2. This is 2. Between 270 and 360, 90, and half of it is 45. So 270 plus 45, that's 315. So the period for A is 315 degrees. The period for B will be 360 degrees. What if you were asked about the phase angle? So the phase angle. First angle is the difference between the two curves that you drew. So the difference between here and here is the first angle, which is likewise the difference from here to here. So if we took 540 for example and would minus from 4. 450 plus 45, that's 195. We'll get the first angle as 45 degrees can also be set to minus the 360 from 315, which is also 45. In short, if we use the formula of y is equal to k cos bx plus theta, and we assume that these three, k, b, and theta, all of them are constants, we'll come to note that k will be the amplitude, and b will be the period of the wave. And our theta would be the phase angle. So, lastly, on the trigonometric equation, I would like to say that we have some special angles, which is 30, 45, and 60. If we want to look for 30 and 60 degrees, we'll use an equilateral triangle. But as per the 45 degrees angle, we'll have to use an isosceles triangle, which is likewise a right angle triangle, whereby its sides are 1-1. And for the equilateral triangle, we will use the triangle with sides 2 centimeters each. So, if we illustrate. Let's assume this is an equilateral triangle. So, 2 centimeters. We all know that an equilateral triangle has, it sums up to an 80, and it has all its angles equal. So, side 60. And since we have dissected it, this is 30. This is 30. This is 40. This is 90. And this is 90. So, we change this 2 centimeters to 1 centimeter each. So, for example, if you want to say we ask what is cos 30, cos 60, for example, cosine for 60 here, we'll say it's cos 60 is equivalent to the adjacent of a hypotenuse, which is 1 over 2. If we use sine 30, which is the same from here, from this side, it will be opposite, which is 1 over the hypotenuse. If we decided to, for example, use the tan theta as well, we'll get that tan theta is opposite of our adjacent. The adjacent is 2 squared as 1, which is 4 minus 1, so the height is root 3. So the tan theta will be opposite, which is 1, adjacent, which is root 3. What do you find common here? You find that cos 60 and sine 30 are similar. So, if, for example, you are given an equation, let's say sine 12, let's write it here. If you are given an equation, for example, sine 12, is equal to cos x
sold this for the values of
0 is less than or equals to x, less than or equals to 2, c, which is equivalent to 360.
We'll say that since cos 60 is equivalent to sin 30, means that when you add this to this 2, you will get 90 degrees. So you'll say 2x plus x is equivalent to 90 degrees. Or 3x will be 90 degrees. or will be x will be 30 degrees. So when you are asked to obtain the values for x, we'll like to go back to trigonometry 2 where we use the circle of whereby we said that this quadrant, first quadrant, let's call this the second, let's call this the third, and this one the fourth one. We said that in the first quadrant, all sine, tangent, cosine are positive. So tangent, cosine, and sine are positive. But in the second quadrant, only sine is positive. The rest are negative. In the third one, tan is positive. Cosine is negative. Sine is negative. In the fourth one, only cosine is positive. The rest are negative. So, this equation could have also been written this way. Say that sine 2x is the same as sine 90 minus x. So, whereby if we got x to be 30, for the values we'll find to be 30 degrees for the sine. For the sine, that is. We'll come to the circle and check which quadrant the sine is positive. So it's in the first and the second. So first angle will be 30 degrees, whereby, and the second angle will be this 30 degrees. Yeah, so the second angle will be 180 degrees as 30 degrees, which will give you 150 degrees. Let's say tan 3x is equal to 2 for the values of 0 and less than or equals to x less than or equals to 360. Oh, we just come and say 3x is the tan inverse of 2. However, if you use the calculator, you get tan inverse for 2 is 63.43. So you will refer back to the circle. And you notice that the tangent is only positive in the first and in the third quadrant. So, first angle, you may say it will be 3x is equivalent to 63.43. So, the first angle is x is equal to 63.43 divided by 3, which is 21.14. So, the other angle will be here, and so at this area you have 180 degrees. So, 180 degrees plus 63.43, whereby you get 253.43. And remember, there was 3x here, so x will be 81.14. We also have to rotate a second time, whereby at
this area, it will be 360. And you add 360 to 63.43. So we will get 423.43. And you equate it to 3x. Probably it gets x is equivalent to 141.14. The limit is not yet reached, so you can still continue. This area, it will be 360 plus 180, which is 40. So this is 40 degrees. You also add it to previous 63.43. Probably you get 603.43 degrees, being equivalent to 3x. And so use the calculator again. Get 2 over 1.14. We will also try to rotate it once more. And so our 360 will be 360 will be 720. So we say that now 720 has 63.43. We get 783.43. We did it to 3x again. You get x maybe. Two sixty one degrees. And if we now go to this other side, it will be 180 plus 540, which is now 720 degrees. You add to 63.43, you get 783.43, and you put it to 3x, you get x is 2. You also you get 261. Sorry, I made a mistake. If we have 720 here, sorry. If you add 180 here, it will be 900, so not 720. So 900, if we add 63.43, and 63.43, quit it to 3x, and you get x to be 321.14. If you decide to rotate it again, you'll get that the other value will not will have exceeded this 360. Practically, we do it now, we get that at 360 times at 20. You add 63.43, you get 11.43 equals to 3x, and therefore I also get 3.14. This value, however, will not qualify to be in this range of values of x. So possible values of x will be it will be 21.14. And 21.14. 21.14. This is the 1.1. It was also H1.1. Yes. Those are the possible values for X. We've come to the end of the discussion. The Sans Hub. My name was Marvin Mundati. Keep it Elimu TV. Bye, Mojanga.